Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. In partnership firm, managing partners, they get salary from the firm. If a particular managing partner dies, firm is required to pay salary till date of his death. This particular adjustment we are going to discuss in this question. Let us go through the question. Sheetal, Anjali, Rajendra were sharing profits and losses as 7:5:4. Their balance sheet as on 31st March is as under. Balance sheet as on 31st March 2012. Capital, Sheetal, Anjali, Rajendra. Capitals are given. Bills payable. Creditors. Loan. We have general reserve. This will be divided in profit sharing ratio among all partners. On asset side, we have furniture, machinery, building, and cash. Rajendra died on 30th June 2012. Balance sheet is given as on 31st March. Rajendra died on 30th June. So April, May, June. After close of last financial year, Rajendra was there in firm for a period of 3 months before his death, and the following adjustments were agreed as per the deed. Furniture, machinery, building are to be revalued. Furniture new value is 16,700. Here we have furniture 17,000. Book value is 17,000. Revised value is 16,700. That means value of furniture is decreased by 300. So from furniture, we are required to decrease amount 300 on asset side. In new balance sheet, furniture will be 16,700. This is a loss for the firm. Therefore, this will be debited to profit and loss adjustment account or revaluation account. Machinery 16,200. Here machinery is 18,000. Revised value is 16,200. That means there is a reduction by 1,800 from machinery. We are required to reduce 1,800. Second effect will be revaluation account debit. Building 30,100. The old value of building is 16,000. New value is 30,100. That means it has gone up. It has gone up by 14,100. This is a gain for the firm, so it will be credited to revaluation account. Rajendra's share of goodwill is to be valued from firm's goodwill, which was valued at 2 times the average profit of last 3 years. Profit of last 3 years were 30,000. 25,000, 25,000, 20,000. This is, they have given for 4 years, but we are required to consider only for 3 years as information is required in the question. His profits up to date of death is to be calculated on the basis of last 3 years' profit. Rajendra was entitled to get a salary of ₹800 per month. He was there in a firm for 3 months before his death. Per month, we are required to consider salary of 800. Interest on capital at 10% be allowed. This will be credited to his capital account. Rajendra's drawings up to date of death were 600 per month. We are required to calculate 3 months drawing. Prepare Rajendra's capital account showing amount payable to his executor and give working of share of goodwill and profit. We are required to prepare working notes for various adjustments, and then finally we'll be preparing Rajendra's capital account. Working note: Rajendra's share of goodwill. Step 1, we are required to find out average profit. They have given us 3 years required profit. We'll be taking total of that. 25,000, 25,000 plus 20,000. Total profit of last 3 years divided by number of years. Total profit of last 3 years 70,000 divided by number of years 3 years. Average profit is 23,333. Step 2, we are required to find firm's total goodwill. As per information given in the question, it is average profit multiplied by number of years purchase. Average profit 23,333 multiplied by number of years purchase 2. So it will be 46,667. Step 3, Rajendra's share in firm's goodwill. Total goodwill or firm's goodwill multiplied by Rajendra's share. Firm's total goodwill is 46,667. Rajendra's profit share is 4 by 16. Thereby, his share of goodwill we get 11,667. Journal entry for this will be goodwill account debit to Rajendra's capital account 11,667. Profit up to date of death of Rajendra is to be calculated on the basis of last year's profit. Second working note is about Rajendra's share in profit of firm till death based on last year's profit. He died on 30th June. That means he is eligible to share profit for a period of 3 months, that is April to June. Last year profit is given 20,000. Rajendra's share in profit till death, that is for 3 months, calculation will be last year's profit multiplied by profit share of Rajendra multiplied by period divided by 12. Last year's profit is 20,000. Profit share of Rajendra 4 by 16. 3 months 3 by 12. So we get answer 1250. This is the share of profit of Rajendra till his death. Entry for this will be profit and loss suspense account debit 1250 to Rajendra's capital account 1250. Rajendra was entitled to get salary of 800 per month. Rajendra's salary for 3 months. Salary per month multiplied by period. It has been agreed to give salary 800 per month multiplied by 3 months. Total salary payable is 2400. This will be credited to Rajendra's capital account. Interest on capital of Rajendra at 10% for 3 months. Rajendra's capital multiplied by rate of interest divided by 100 multiplied by period divided by 12. Rajendra's capital is 12,000. Rate of interest 10%. Period is 3 by 12, that is 3 months. We get answer 300. This amount will be credited to Rajendra's capital account. We have completed working notes. Let us proceed to prepare profit and loss adjustment account or revaluation account to find revaluation profit or loss upon death of Rajendra. Furniture, machinery, building revalued. Furniture 16,700. Book value was 17,000. So it has got reduced by 300. This 300 will be debited to revaluation account. Revaluation account debit to furniture account 300. Machinery new value 16,200. Old value here is 18,000. So it has decreased by 1,800. This will be debited to revaluation account. Revaluation account debit to machinery account 1,800. Building revalued at 30,100. Book value is 16,000. So it has gone up by 14,100. This will be credited to revaluation account. Revaluation account credit by building 14,100. Now we can close revaluation account to find out revaluation profit or loss. Revaluation profit total amount is 12,000. It is divided between Sheetal, Anjali and Rajendra in their profit sharing ratio. Sheetal got 5,250, Anjali 3,750, Rajendra 3,000. Share of Rajendra will be transferred to his capital account on credit side. Let us prepare now Rajendra's capital account. Rajendra's capital is showing ₹12,000 balance as on 31st March. This will become opening balance of his capital. Rajendra's capital account credit by balance brought down ₹12,000. General reserve total amount is 16,000. Rajendra's share is 4 by 16. So it will be 4,000. This will be credited to his capital account. Rajendra's capital account credit by general reserve 4,000. According to first adjustment, there are revaluation of three assets. We have prepared revaluation account. Revaluation account shows profit. Share of Rajendra will be credited to his capital account 3,000. Rajendra's capital account credit by revaluation account profit transferred 3,000. Rajendra's share of goodwill based on last 3 years' profit. We have prepared working note to calculate Rajendra's share of goodwill. We have calculated average profit, firm's total goodwill, and based on that, Rajendra's share is 11,667. Rajendra's capital account credit by goodwill account 11,667. His profit up to date of death is to be calculated on the basis of last year's profit. We have done working note for this. Rajendra's share in profit of firm till death based on last year's profit. Last year profit was 20,000. Based on that, we have calculated 3 months share of Rajendra, which comes to 1,250. This will be credited to his capital account. Rajendra's capital account credit by profit and loss suspense account 1,250. Rajendra to get salary of 800 per month. Rajendra's salary for 3 months. Per month salary 800 multiplied by 3 months 2,400. Similarly, we have interest on capital of Rajendra at 10% per annum for 3 months. So capital multiplied by rate of interest multiplied by period, we got the amount 300. These two amounts, 2400 and 300, will be credited to his capital account by salary of 3 months, 2400, by interest on capital for 3 months, 300. Rajendra's drawings up to date of death, 600 per month. This will be debited to his capital account. Rajendra's capital account debit to drawings, 600 per month multiplied by 3 months. So total amount is 1800. We have recorded all adjustments relating to Rajendra's capital. Let us close his account. Rajendra's capital account credit total is 34,617. After deducting debit 1800, finally we got balance payable 32,817. This will be transferred to Rajendra's executor's loan account. In this question, we have discussed and learned various adjustments relating to deceased partner's capital, particularly salary payable to deceased partners for the period up to his death. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and subscribe to our channel Ikeda. Thank you.